In the last video, we simulated the preheating of the crude oil. In this video, we will simulate atmospheric distillation column, which has three side strippers and three pump rounds. So this is the flow sheet we have done last time. Now we will install a distillation column to separate the stream S8. We will install reflux absorber. For the heating at the bottom, we will install an arbitrary energy stream. Leave all the options blank. Once we will input the side operations, then in the monitor section, we will input our required variables. Go to side ops and side ops input expert. There are two types of side strippers. One is recoil side stripper, in which there is a recoiler at the bottom that will hit the bottom of the column. While the second is steam strip, in which the steam will enter at the bottom to heat the product. I will use the second option. AGO is atmospheric gas oil. We don't have a side rectifier. We have three pump rounds. We don't have any vapor bypass. Now we need to specify the draw rate from the side stripper. In the pump round, we need to define two different variables. First, we need to define the flow basis and the pump round flow rate. In the second option specification, we need to define either of these four: change in temperature due to pump around, return temperature, duty, or return vapor fraction. I will use the return temperature for all four of three options. The operating pressure of the side stripper will remain as default, and 0 is the pressure drop for pump around. Now we have attached our side stripper and pump around. We'll go to the connection and you can see all the inlet and outlet streams. One more stream that we need to be defined, which is the energy stream that will enter at the bottom. Now we will define the streams that will enter at the bottom. Now we will define the efficiencies of each stage. The necessary details related to the simulation is available in this Excel sheet. I have placed the link in the description. Now we need to define the variables to make the degree of freedom 0. So I will define the distillate rate and the vapor product rate. I will keep the vapor product rate 0, and for distillate rate I will select the volumetric option and define the rate 139.8. First, let's delete the unnecessary specifications. Still we have a degree of freedom 1, so we need to define one more specification, that would be bottom temperature. Now we can run our simulation. Our column column has been converged. However, the draw flow rates are good for the initial estimation, but to get the product as per the specification, we need to define the cut points for kerosene, diesel and atmospheric gas oil. So in the specification, we will use the cut point option. First will be kerosene cut point, and we know we are drawing the product from the bottom of the kerosene side stripper. A type will be D86, and the cut point value will be 95 at the temperature of 273.9. We will define the cut point for diesel and atmospheric gas oil as well. The more you guess the right value, the more you will closer to the cut point, and the more it will be easier to converge the column. So I will deactivate the flow specification and activate the respective cut point one by one and make the tower converge. For kerosene, it has been converged. Now similarly for diesel, and atmospheric gas oil. Now this time the product from the kerosene, diesel and AGO size stripper will meet the specification of the standard. In the next video, we will simulate the vacuum distillation column, and the atmospheric bottom will be the feed of the column.